Welcome back guys to my channel Let's Smile to Solve Problems. So today is the lecture 2 for the subject Biology for Engineers, and today the topic which we will be dealing with is the comparison between the human eye and the camera. So previously we came to know about science and engineering. What were the differences and what were the similarities which we have already seen, and the relation also which we have seen. So now let's see the comparison between the human eye and the camera. Okay, so let's see. So first of all, it is the parts of human eye. So let's bring an eye for us. This is a human eye. Similarly, now we will see the parts of a camera. So this is a camera. So there are basic 5 parts for both of them. The 5 parts for the parts of human eye is retina, iris, pupil, lens, choroid. And on the other hand, for the parts of camera, in place of retina it is card or film, in place of iris it is diaphragm, in place of pupil it is aperture, in place of lens it's always a lens for camera also, and in place of choroid it's the black point. So we will see each of them one by one. So now is that the parts of human eye and camera. So the first thing is that it says that pupil and aperture. You basically, these two things here is specifying the similarities. That is, the pupil is in our human eye and aperture in the camera. So both of them, how they are similar to each other in their respective place. So in pupil, light enters through the pupil of human eye. That means our human eye, from where the light enters, is the pupil. Pupil works in the human eye for the entering of the light. And similarly for the camera, light enters through the aperture of the camera. Okay, now the next is our iris and diaphragm. So what does iris do? It regulates the amount of light entering the human eye. That means the light which is entered through the pupil, it must be regulated by the iris. So how much amount must be entered through a human eye? Similarly, the diaphragm regulates the amount of light entering the camera. So you can see that both of them must have the similarities here. So if I bring a picture for this, so this is the camera and this is the eye. So this black portion is a pupil, whereas the iris is the outside the black eyeball portion. Okay, and now see, aperture is the middle portion of this camera and the diaphragm is the outward portion. So now let's move on to the next parts of human eye and camera. So now we will know about the lens in both of the human eye as well as the camera. So what does lens do? You can see it's a function. Whatever we are doing here now, it's a function and the similarities between both the human eye and the camera. So lens focus the light and the image on the retina of human eye. So what does lens do? It focuses the light and the image in the retina, whereas the lens for the camera focuses the light and image, but in the film, or you can say, see, there are two types of camera. One is film camera, one is digital camera. If somebody is using the digital camera, they will be having card. So it will focus at the card of the camera. If they are having the film camera, then they will be focusing on the film. Okay, now it says film and retina. So both of them, what they do, they forms the image. That means here the image formation occurs. That means film and retina, image formation will occur. So if we see, this whole portion is camera lens, and similarly this portion, the eye, is a lens. So this is the picture form of a lens. Now this is the film. So this portion is the film where the image formation occurs in the camera, and this is the portion in the human eye which is the retina portion for the human eye. Okay. Now again we will see the parts of human eye and camera, but now what we will do, now we will see where does basically all these parts are. So this portion is my eye, that means this is the human eye, and this is my camera. So there are five arrows in each of them. So let's bring all the parts first. So this is the part for the human eye, and this is the part for the camera. So the first thing is a retina. So the retina is a this portion, and the card is a this portion or the film, you can see. Iris is a this portion, whereas our eye diaphragm for the camera is this portion. Pupil is this one, this blue portion, whereas here the aperture is this middle gap which is being between the two black lines. Now the lens for the human eye is this, and the lens for the camera is this one, and the choroid is this portion, and the black point is this portion. Okay, so these are the five basic parts for both human eye and camera through the diagram where it's been showing. So one part we have left over with is one is choroid and black point. So what are the similarities between them, or you can see the functions which are performed by this. So what happens in the melanin of the choroid, it absorbs the light and limits the reflection within the eye and prevents vision degradation. So see, light enters from the pupil, right? So what happens when light enters? So the choroid portion function is that it absorbs the light and limits the reflection so that the eye doesn't degrade its vision. And whereas the black point also do the same thing, but it does for the camera. Okay, so the black point of camera absorb light and limit the reflection within the camera. And so I hope you understood till this. So let's move on. So now we will see the difference between human eye and camera. So let's bring the human eye and the camera. So first difference is that retina retains the impression of image for 1/16th of a second. That means what happens when we see an image, so it will keep the impression of that image for 1/16th of a second. But when we do a photograph or when we click an image from the camera, so it retains the image permanently. That means it gets stored in the memory of the camera. Okay, this was the first difference. The second difference is that the distance between retina and lens is constant, and the distance between the film and the lens can be changed. So for this we need a diagram. So this was our diagram. So it says this is a retina, so this is a lens. For human eye it can't be changed. We can't change a distance which is between retina and the lens, because it is constant, it is fixed in our eyes, right? Whereas in camera we can change. This is a film and this is a lens, so we can adjust in camera, right? We can focus, right? So now let's move on to the other differences, which are for the human eye and the camera is. So this is the third difference, that retina views unlimited number of images. So I see, we are seeing something and again we are seeing another thing. So it can see number of images, unlimited, it's infinite. Whatever we can see, it's infinity number of images. But a photograph has to be changed to get to the next photograph. If we are clicking a photograph or if we are taking an image, we can't take another image at that point of time. We need to shift that photograph or the image and then we will again capture the image, right? But retina views unlimited number of images at a time. That means at the same time we can view a TV as well as we can view our mobile. So it is an unlimited number of images. Okay, now the fourth difference is that image form with help of specialized cells, rod and cone cells on the retina, which is processed by the brain. That means whatever the image we are seeing through a human eye is formed due to some specific cells that are rod and cone cells, which are on the retina, which gets processed by the brain. Okay, but the image formed in the camera is through a chemical, which is silver nitrate, which are developed, or we can also develop the images through the computer. And the last difference is that the lens and eyeballs are flexible, but the lens and the body are rigid for the camera. So this is the diagram. So this is a lens and the whole thing is a eyes, right? So we can move our eyeballs and see everything. So it is flexible, but we can't move our body and lens, right? In the camera, it is rigid, it is constant, we can't change. So these two things about human eye and the camera is that you need to know about the parts, you need to know how does all the parts function, and you also need to know all the functions which are similar to the other with the camera. And the last thing is the difference between human eye and the camera. So I have done in such a manner that it will be easier for you to remember, because I have given you diagrams so you can remember all of these points. Okay, so I hope all of you understood the lecture, and thank you for watching, and till then be happy and have a great day.
Now is the cool time. A little progress each day adds up to big sum. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel, and do press the bell icon for latest videos.